This presentation is on attributes of steel, but it is aimed at the building construction profession from my perspective as an architect. Instead of delving upon the physical and technical attributes of steel, I would prefer to leave that to the steel specialists. Technical advice, I think, should better be sought from the steel construction industry. And the main aim of my presentation, therefore, is to proliferate the brain cells of the designers, builders, and architects in this direction of promoting steel. Steel has long been only a standby material for architectural framework. That is where our focus should be now. If we are successful in making steel recognized for innate beauty as well as its structural integrity, the results can be awe-inspiring. Revered architects such as Zaha Hadid, Frank Gehry, Moshe Saudi, to name a few, have challenged the idea of using steel merely to construct a building skeleton and have instead created innovative and surprisingly fluid structures that allow the material to take center stage. What's more, many modern architects are experimenting with the aesthetics of steel, from cultivating rust for an aged patina to polishing for a high shine, to bronzing for a warmer finish. Today, architects and designers use steel as an integral element in their creative work. If used aptly, steel is surely an exceptional material. It is also at the core of green economy, in which economical growth and environmental responsibility work hand in hand. Its versatility and recyclability have also brought about countless innovative applications that, when seen from a product lifecycle perspective, provide savings that neutralize and often far outweigh the initial material production impacts. Its durability also allows for the reuse of countless products, which is enhanced through proper design. This saves natural resources. Steel buildings are the future for providing sustainable development. These are all points that are everybody has discussed maybe before me, but now I will take up certain aspects of steel after this, which in certain buildings which I have done, and in certain buildings which other architects also taken up. You must be all knowing that heavy steel structures provide inspired solutions for complex structures. It's just a matter of arranging an optimized structural design with pre-engineered systems, giving the best value of strength, economy, and aesthetics. Its construction is faster, easily transportable in segments, can be fabricated off-site, erected at site, thereby giving huge amounts of flexibility. Project completion time is reduced considerably as against conventional system of construction. It reduces wastage. All possible shapes and large sizes are all easy to construct, especially large cantilevers, which may be a challenge in conventional construction. And if one goes into cost-benefit analysis, it can be seen that steel construction is actually economical. Designers and architects today use steel as a critical element in their creative work, driving material imagination and shaping a design. When the realm of ideas and realm of experimentation merge, form is animated with meaning. There is an effective strategy open to architects. Whereas doctors deal with internal constituents of man, architects deal with the exterior. If imaginatively conceived and deftly executed, architecture has the ability to impact the design internal constituents of man by way of positive energy it creates for well-being. Steel industry in India is re-evaluating their strategies by targeting the costs and educating the professionals. A report of McKinsey projects that by 2030, the total urban population of India will be 590 million. 40% of the Indian population would thereby be living in urban areas. India may require constructing an additional Chicago each year for the next 20 years. This would require tall buildings to cater to all needs by overcoming shortage of spaces as well as resources, and also to race against time as quickly as possible. With that, I would like to share a few steel buildings that I feel are incredible examples of modern architecture, enough to motivate everyone. Few buildings that we have also showcased. This is Frank Gehry's Walt Disney Concert Hall in Los Angeles. Zaha Hadid InvestiCorp building. I'll just take it up quickly because this is just to bring out what all is possible. Museum of Contemporary Art, Cleveland. These are all steel buildings, various shapes. Kauffman Center for the Performing Art in Kansas City. This is Thames Burial, London. Tokyo GMI building. This is a residence in Western Connecticut. There are a lot of planes in this. This is a house with a lot of planes. This is a building in Turkey. And these are some of the buildings that we have been trying. This is a hotel that is coming up shortly in India. This is sketch stage right now. This is a building that is already completed. Left side is the 3D view, and the right side is the completed building. This is a velodrome we have tried. It's another view of the same. You can see the forms that can easily be done in steel. This is a building we have completed in Jaipur. It's a jewelry showroom. These kind of buildings can only be possible in steel. The shape and the form and all, not possible in concrete. So we've been experimenting with the material and have successfully done it so far. This was the tower design competition we tried in Taiwan. All the animals that you see in the bottom, these are all in steel. And they house the museum part of the complex. Some more views are the same. This is a temple that is coming up in Delhi. So this is entire structure is steel. So I'd like to say thank you to everybody for listening.